The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 16th Chapter, text number 17, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on January 12, 1974, in Los Angeles.
Translation. Now you may have heard from me of what happened while Maharaj Parikshit was passing his days hearing of the good occupations of his forefathers and being absorbed in thought of them.
So the question was how Maharaj Parikshit punished this Kali Yuga. The chapter name is How Parikshit Received the Age of Kali. So why he punished the Kali? Because yet he said, Purvesham Vritti Annaham Tasya Vartamanasya. You are situated always on the platform where his forefathers remain. This is called aristocracy. Every family or every caste, family, first of all there must be division, then family, community, society, then family. So, Parikshit Maharaj belonged to the royal family. His forefathers or Bharat Vamsa, the Bharat dynasty. Therefore, you'll find the members of the Bharat dynasty is called Bharat. Bharat. So Arjuna was addressed by Krishna as Bharat. Maharaj Dhritarashtra was also addressed as Bharat. Vidur was addressed as Bharat. Many times you have seen it. So, these descendants of the Bharata dynasty, especially, not specially, all of them. When Parikshit Maharaj was born, so I have told you already, learned scholars in astrology, they were calculating the horoscope of the newly born child. So he was being described that this child, this baby now born, he will be hero like this, he will be devotee like this, he will be, this is horoscope man, in future what he will be. So Maharaj Yudhishthir was anxious and he informed the learned Brahmins that this is all right, I thank you for your calculation. First of all, I want to know whether he will follow his forefathers. I want to know. That was the question. Because that Bharata dynasty, they are rulers of the world, emperor and great devotees at the same time. Evam parampara pratam imam raja rishayo vidu. They were not emperors and kings, simply tax collectors. No. They were raja rishayo, rajarshi. Rajarshi means royal majesty. But in their behavior, they are exactly like great saintly person, Raja and Rishi. That is called Rajarshi. Raja means royal king, and Rishi means saintly person. There are many examples of Rajarshi, just like Rajarshi Janak, Janak Maharaj, Rajarshi Prahlad Maharaj, Rajarshi Dhruva Maharaj, Rajarshi Yudhishthir Maharaj, Rajarshi Parikshit Maharaj, all the kings almost, when monarchy was accepted, that is the only thing, monarchy must be accepted. But at the present moment, democracy means abolish monarchy and elect a rascal as monarch. This is called democracy. But after all, you have to accept a man this leg should not be spread before the deity. Monarchy, that is required, monarchy. Because a monarch is Rajarshi, he should be Rajarshi, a saintly person. Without being saintly person, how he can become representative of God? A king is supposed to be representative of God. So unless he has got godly character, saintly character, great devotee, how he can become the head of a state, just like the demigods in the heavenly planets? The king of heaven is Indra. So Indra is materially very opulent, although they are after material enjoyment. You cannot compare their material enjoyment with this material enjoyment on this earthly planet. There are thousand times better standard. The duration of life, paraphernalia for enjoyment, facilities, so many things. They are higher and higher. As you go to the higher planet, they are higher and higher, thousand times. Just like in this planet also we see that some nation's standard of living is higher than other nation. Take for example, you Americans, your standard of living, from material point of view, you have got greater facilities, or you have created your own good facilities. Similarly, the more the intelligent persons are, they create their own facilities by the grace of God. Just like in this America, the Red Indians are there, but they could not develop the country. But when the Europeans came and settled in this country, now this country has become the first-class country in comparison to other countries. So it is the intelligence. So the standard of living, intelligence, increases as you go higher, 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 higher. Urdham gacchanti sattvastva. Urdham means higher, higher. And adho gacchanti tamasa. There are three qualities. The whole material world is being operated under the influence of three qualities. Traiguna visaya veda nistraiguna bhavarjuna. So, according to the quality, there are different grades of people. And that is called chaturbarnamaya system gunakarma vibhagas. So, everyone is not on the same platform. Everyone is under the influence of some quality of nature, goodness, passion, ignorance. So there is division. So the Kshatriyas, they are supposed to be in the mode of passion, a desire for controlling, ruling. That is Kshatriya spirit, ruling. Therefore, one Kshatriya king used to attack another Kshatriya king. The idea is not to take possession of others' property. The idea was that this king is not ruling nicely. Just like in your country, you want to change the president, but forcibly he is sitting in his position. So, as you want good government, a good man as president, similarly, formally, although there was fight between the two kings, the objective was different, not to occupy one's property. Not to become a big thief. You know the story of Alexander the Great and the thief. Alexander the Great arrested one thief and he was going to punish him. The thief pleaded, "Sir, you are going to punish me, but what is the difference between you and me? I am a small thief, you are a great thief, that's all. You are, by force, occupying other's kingdom and you have no right, but because you are strong or somewhere or other, you have got the opportunity and you are conquering country after country, country after country. So I am also doing the same thing. So what is the difference between you and me?" So Alexander considered that, "Yes, I am nothing but a big thief, that's all." So he released him. "Yes, I am no better than you." Just like dacoits. Nowadays, there are many thieves who steal scientifically, legally. There are many lawyers, many scientists. They do harm, but legally. Legal murderer, legal cheaters, so many things. We have got experience, every one of us. If you can protect yourself under the cover of law and you cheat others, then it is nice. But you cannot cheat the supervision of the Supreme, that you cannot do. A thief may steal secretly, but there is no secret. There is no secrecy for God. It is said in the Bhagavad Gita, "Sarvasya chaham hridi sannivishtya." I am sitting in everyone's heart. So suppose you are planning to do something mischievous activity. You can cheat the man-made law or the man-made police, but how you can cheat Krishna? He is sitting within your heart. "Sarvasya chaham hridi sannivishtya." I am sitting in everyone's heart. So whatever you thinking, feeling and willing, it is immediately being observed and noted. This rascal wants to do this. Besides that, this is inside. Then outside, there is sun, there is moon, there is day, there is night. Everyone, there are eight kinds of witnesses, whatever you doing. And karmanādhayo netrena. Just like a man is punished according to his gravity of criminality. Similarly, whatever you are doing, here everything is criminal in this material world. Everything is criminal. Therefore, Chaitanya Chaitamrita Kar says, "Dvaite bhadra bhadra sakali samana. Ei bhala ei manda sab monodhar." Dvaite. Dvaite means things which is not directly Krishna. Dvaita. Bhayang ditya abhinivesatasya ditya. This ditya, this is called maya. Ditya means second. The one is Krishna and maya is secondary. Just like light, light and darkness. Darkness is not first, light is first. And darkness means where there is no light. But there is no, there is darkness. Similarly, darkness has no separate existence. It is simply absence of light. That's all. Real existence is light. So whole creation is just like real existence is the sun. Try to understand, very easy. Sun, but when it is covered by the cloud, it is called darkness. Or it is covered by another planet, then we find darkness. Actually, there is always light. If you go through the cloud, you come to the sunshine, everyone has got the experience. Down, when you start your plane, it may be very dark. And then, when you go beyond the sky, 7 miles above, then you see there is sunlight. And again, if you start your plane in sunlight in the morning, in daylight, say in the morning, and go to the western side, you will find never night. You will find never night. Always light, always light. Sometimes we have got experience, we start from a place, say at 10 o'clock, and going western side, then after a few hours we see that it is still 10 o'clock and the light is there. This is our practical experience. So, actually, there is nothing material, everything spiritual. Spiritual means Ishavasamidam Sarvam, everything belonging to God. But when we think that there is no God, I am God, or it is mine, that is darkness. This consciousness is darkness. So Krishna consciousness movement means to be situated above this material conception. Ahang mameti. Janasya moho ayang ahang mameti. This conception that I am the proprietor and everything belongs to me, this conception is called illusion. And this illusion increases by mental speculation. Ultimately, that mental speculator remains in darkness, but he thinks that he has become liberated. This is another darkness. Another darkness. That is described in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Jinnera Bindyakha Vimukta Manina. He Aravindyakha. Krishna's name is Jannera Vindyakha Vimukta Manina Tayasta Bhavad Abhushuddha Buddhaya Arujya Kichina Parang Padang Tataha Patanti Adha Patanti Adha Anadita Jismad Angraya. Prahlad Maharaj said, my Lord, Aravinda Akhya. Krishna is another name, as I explained yesterday. God has no name, but he has got thousands and millions of names according to his relationship with the devotee or the world, like that. As I explained yesterday, Krishna is called Devaki Nandan because he has got relationship with Devaki. Therefore he has become Devaki Nandan. Krishna is called Jasodhanandan. So similarly, Krishna's another name is Aravindakya. Aravinda, because his eyes are just like petals of the lotus flower. Aravinda Nabha. Aravinda Nabha means Vishnu, Lord Vishnu, Gadbhudak Sai Vishnu. From his navel, while lotus flower is grown. Therefore it's called Aurobindo Nama. So here Krishna is addressed, He Aurobindakya, Janne Aurobindakya. Je Anne, Anne means neglectfully, alas. Prominent men are especially mentioned. Here is Mr. Satan, Satan, Satan. And there are others. So these others, he Aurobindakya, Janne. Who are that others? Janne Aurobindakya Vimukta Manina. The others means less intelligent class of men who are thinking that I am now liberated, I have now become God by mystic yoga, by meditation. So therefore it is called manina. Manina when they are thinking wrongly like that. Actually they are not liberated. Not liberated. They are in darkness because he is foolishly thinking that he has become God. How you can become God? What is your power? What you have shown like God? We accept God, Krishna, Lord Ramchandra and others by seeing his activities. Krishna, at the age of 7 years old, he lifted Govardhan Mountain, Govardhanadhari, Giridhari. So what you have? You cannot raise even 5 kilos of load. And you are becoming God. So these so-called gods are accepted by so-called devotees. These are all rascals. Therefore it is called manina. They are thinking by mental speculation that I have become God. What you have got power, what you have done, that you have become God. But they are foolish. They do not calculate the value of his, strength of his becoming God, but they are thinking. Therefore it is called manina. Then you can think at your home that I am the proprietor of the Bank of America. So you may become a crazy fellow like that, but to become proprietor of the Bank of America is a different thing. But these foolish men will think like that. I am God, I am moving the sun, I am moving. This is their meditation. Perhaps you know. These rascals, these dogs, not gods, they think like that. I am moving the sun, I am moving the earth. Therefore it is called vimukta manina. Manina, thinking, foolishly, thinking. Janneru vindaka vimukta manina. Why they are thinking foolishly? We see they are advanced in knowledge, they can put forward so many words about becoming God. That has been described by Sridhar Swami, Bak Chaturj. Their so-called explanation that they have become God, that has been described by Vakchaturja, jugglery of words, to be fool another fool. That's therefore in Bhagavad, in another place, it is said that Sabiri Varaha Ustakharoi Sangstuta Purushappasu Purushappasu. If one person who is not devotee, if he is praised as very exalted, so where from these praising words are coming? Na sabir varaha ustakharai. Such praising comes from the persons who are like dogs. So, bir varaha, these 2-liter pigs, sabir varaha ustra, camel, and khara means ass. These classes of men, they praise such another big animal, sabir varaha ustra, because anyone who is not a devotee of the Lord, He is not Rajarshi, Devarshi. He is not praiseworthy at all. He is a fool, he is a rascal. That is our conclusion. Now it is the real conclusion. Because Krishna says, Murha. Murha means rascal. Namang duskitinam murha prapadante naradhama. So our simple test is whether a man is devotee or not. If we find that he is a devotee, then we respect. Yes, he is nice. Vaishnava. Him Jamaraja says, offer my respect to the Vaishnava. But if we see that he is not a devotee, he is claiming himself as God, as the Supreme, then immediately, according to the formula of Bhagavad Gita, we accept murha. Because a murha does not surrender. A murha, that is the test. Anyone who has not surrendered to the principle of Bhagavad Gita, sarva dharman parityajyamami ekam saranam vraja, that is the test. If he has not surrendered to God or Krishna, then he is murha. That is also explained in the Bhagavad. Jannero vindakho vimuktamanina. Why they are so murhas? Just like cause and effect. If a man has no money, he is called poor. Poor man. Similarly, if a man has no such sense to surrender unto God, he is murha. He is murha. So, but thinking that he has become liberated, he has become one with God and he is God himself, everyone is God. Therefore, they are murha. Janneiro bindakha vimukta manina. So, it is in good words, vimukta manina. And because it is said by Vyasadeva, or a devotee, little respectful, vimukta manina, falsely thinking that he has become liberated. But when Krishna says, because he is the Supreme Lord, he says it is a murha, he is a rascal. That's a father can immediately call his son rascal, or spiritual master can say, because superior position, rascal. Others, the rascal may be addressed in a ornamented language. Thank you very much.